The previous week, we had the privilege of hosting Dr. Rebecca Richard on our show to educate us about fish farming. It's my sincere hope that his insights proved valuable changes on so many people who are interested in fish farming. Today on the Harvest Money Show, we bring back Dr. Rebecca Richard to deliver more aspects on his farm. The search for the best farmer is still going on, which is supported by the Netherlands Embassy in Uganda, Royal Dutch Airlines, Cowdice, and DFCU Bank. Welcome to the Harvest Money Show. My name is Rosemary Tukondani.
In the latest episode of the Harvest Money Show, we have the pleasure of featuring Dr. Richard Lubega, a professional doctor who has made a successful transition to agriculture. Despite holding a degree in public health and health promotion, a diploma in clinical medicine and community health, and a certificate in administrative law, Dr. Lubega has found that agriculture is a fulfilling and lucrative way to improve his life and the lives of those in his community. Dr. Lubega's 2.5-acre farm, located in Busesa village, Matale sub-county, Kibale district in western Uganda, is an active hub of activity. In addition to agriculture, which was the focus of our last episode, Dr. Lubega also engages in piggery, poultry, goat rearing, and cattle keeping. His farm is also home to the Busesa Medical Center 3, located at the heart of Busesa town. Although Dr. Lubega is the driving force behind the farm's success, he is quick to credit his family for their involvement, particularly his wife, Betty Nabusana. The farm is a testament of Dr. Lubega's entrepreneurial spirit and his dedication to improving the lives of those in his community. As you drive on Kakumiro Road and reach Kibale District, you simply cannot miss the Busesa Medical Center, a testament to Dr. Lubega's commitment to his community's health and well-being. Within the Busesa farm lies a thriving poultry enterprise, which upon inquiry is said to be under the able management of none other than Dr. Richard Lubega's wife, affectionately referred to as Madame. While Betty initially held qualifications in computer science and secretariat, her entry into the world of agriculture began with the management of the farm's goats and piggery. However, her evident aptitude for farming has led her to start a new enterprise within the farm, and by all accounts, the poultry venture is flourishing under her watchful eye.
I was eager to do it because I loved it, because we used to do that practice at school. So I was interested because I was ever working there. When I joined this farming section, we had to get some school fees. It encouraged me to continue doing farming. We are getting a lot from the farming projects.
Yeah. Betty has not abandoned her computer science and secretariat profession. She continues to work in the hospital's secretarial office up to this day. However, the question remains, how is she managing to balance her work in the office, her responsibilities at home, and her farm?
It's all about time, managing your time. So I plan earlier in the morning. I wake up as early as I can to look after the farm, to see what is taking place and everything, so that by 8 I report down. Then even in the afternoon I come and check on them. So it's all about managing time. You can catch up with everything.
Betty, the esteemed manager at Busesa Farm, highlights the crucial role played by the flourishing poultry enterprise, which is currently home to the impressive flock of 500 birds. Undoubtedly, this profitable venture has emerged as a valuable asset for the farm, thanks to its unwavering popularity in the market. In addition to this, every bird raised on the farm is swiftly sold, resulting into a constant and substantial flow of revenue for the enterprise. In the free-range farming system, Dr. Richard Lubega engages in the rearing of boer goats, albeit on a small scale. However, what captured our interest was the remarkable level of obedience displayed by these goats towards the farm owner. Witnessing these animals submissively trail Dr. Lubega back to their residence was truly a sight to behold. Dr. Lubega's success in goat farming is well known, but what is lesser known is his foray into piggery, where he has utilized 2.5 acres of land. Our visit to his farm, which also houses a medical center, left us pleasantly surprised as there were no foul smells lingering in the air. Intrigued, we probed deeper into his methods and discovered the secrets behind his immaculate hygiene standards. During our interview, Dr. Lubega shared his expertise on pig breeds, best practices for pig rearing, and the innovative IMO method that keeps the bad smell at bay.
This enterprise of piggery, actually it is one of the projects I started in 2014. Piggery, actually I started with local pigs, but as I went on, I saw these pigs, the local pigs were not working on well. They had some other challenges. So basing on those challenges, I had to research that if I want to venture much into this piggery and get profits, what can I do? What can I do to make sure that I get good pigs and I get profits out of it? First of all was to look at the breed. The local breed was not important. Then I searched and found out that there was a breed called Cambraff. The Cambraff breed, actually when you look at it, it grows faster. At 6 months, it can mate, if it is a male, even it can conceive, if it's a female. You can even say it has reached its full stage. Two, the good thing with the Cambraff, it can produce many piglets. Now this one, it is between 10 to 15 piglets when it one delivery. So you find the project tend to grow very fast. Three, you find these Cambraff pigs, they are not breaking in feeding, because now this pig, it is over 200 kilograms. But in the morning, I give it 1 kilogram, in the afternoon, 1 kilogram, and in the evening, 1 kilogram. What makes these pigs grow faster and bigger? It's not just food, but water. You have to make sure your pigs have enough water. That's why we had to innovate and have these nipples. When I tried to search on science of the pigs, they are not meant to take water sip at once. They are meant to take little by little. They eat and take, eat and take. So we looked at those who use it to pour water that this pig will take. It would take once, this water gets dirty, and in the end, it stops taking it. It just play in it over. Then it will not be taking water. But when you have these nipples, it will take this water from the nipple, and even it will not take this dirty one. That means if you had put it here, you would be limiting it. And what makes it feel comfortable, not to find it when it is breathing, when it is having high temperatures and the like, is frequent taking of water. This water
system or with a nipple, anybody can have it. You don't need to have electricity to have this nipple water. No. You just have to get your tank, raise it up, when you get your stands, put the power into the tank. Then you connect down the plumbing system. You will be able to use this. Now, after starting, I also found that pigs which were kept in concrete-made structures with cement and the like, they were too expensive. And for me, when I'm beginning a venture, I make sure I look at where I put in a little, but get a lot. Like emo structures you are seeing. These emo structures, you have to dig a pit down, 3 feet. Then you have to pour in this sawdust. You can go from where they are plumbing, they are doing lumbering. You can access these ones. Then you pour it up to 2 feet of that pitch. Now, the one foot that remains on top, you preserve it to be covered by this trough. So this trough is seated on a firm ground. It is not part of the ditch of the 3 feet. It is just on top where you put your trough for feed and the trough for collecting this leaking water from the pig that you cannot take. This also makes it hygienic. When you want to have an emo structure, it has to be dry, because if this water happened to flow and come in here, it will mean now this may not be emo now. It can actually harbor some infections. It can harbor those fungal infections. Even it can produce heat, which heat can even affect this pig. The ones and it may get into swine fever maybe. The virus can have good environment to grow. Now, what is emo? Emo structures, that is in full, it is using inorganic microorganisms. Now, the science there, when this pig releases its waste, the microorganism, bring me that bucket, drum. So you find, bring it for me. Now you find those microorganisms, it is called vetiline powder. The vetiline powder, what is my contain of vetiline powder? Do you have it? You bring it here. From here. So now, the vetiline powder. Where is it? Now, this one, you have to. This tin called vetiline powder. This vetiline powder, you get the powder from it and mix it into water. The whole of this can accommodate 5 jerrycans. This can mix 5 jerrycans. But you try to estimate, like this one, we normally make of 2 jerrycans. When you put 2 jerrycans here of water, we get some like 3 spoons of vetiline powder put in. You cover it well, and you can put in maize bran. Now, this maize bran acts as food for these microorganisms. So you have to leave it for a period of 4 to 7 days. From 4 to 7 days, microorganisms will have started growing. Then you get your water. This water, you will see it even having some microorganisms which have started growing. So when you just get, have to smash it into the structure. So these microorganisms will grow. After growing, this pig, as soon as it drops its waste, those microorganisms will have multiplied and they start eating on it. In 3 hours, you will not see the waste where it has gone. It becomes dust. It breaks it into dust. And that dust will keep on coming in for around 5 to 6 months. This dust will rise and you find it getting into soil. Then that is the time you are supposed to remove this sawdust and put into the farm. This is actually, even if it is half a cup, it's enough of this water. Because there are a lot of microorganisms here. When you spray, you sprinkle around, there is a lot of microorganisms there. But and after putting, they keep on multiplying. You don't have to put a lot. They will multiply themselves around.
As we delve into the ongoing Best Farmers competition, one of the key parameters under scrutiny is record keeping. During our interview with Dr. Lubega, he shared with us that since he began closely monitoring his farm, he saw it fit to implement a comprehensive record-keeping system for the piggery section.
With this farm, actually, I think what before I used it to just work, but when I went on, I could not understand how this business would. I was benefiting from this business. Then I had to introduce the book system. When you come to the farm, I think you'll go there and see. For these all projects, the fishery, the goats, the poultry, the cows, the agent banking and the ICT, as she told you, we have one cashier who has a degree in accounting. Every money that is sold here, even from the facility, is handled by one person. But these books are different. We have farm books and we have medical books. So when you buy a pig from here, you have to go there and get a receipt. And after getting a receipt, she will enter into the cash book. From the cash book, if this doctor of mine is going to buy, as we shall see, the concentrates and the pellets, has to write an invoice requesting for money to buy those things, and I have to sign on them. You cannot get money before that invoice gets my signature. Yeah, because you cannot. Maybe we can be online if it is so urgent. I have to be notified. This is the farm record. This farm record for this one. You have, even you people, you have to sign here. The first person to sign in this book, it was in 2019. It was on 18th June 2019. That's when the first person started. Actually here, this is a demo site for this area, for the Western region, I can say, as far as Cambrough pigs are concerned. So whoever comes to get training for this farm, you have to sign here. Two, now we have gotten a chance. Many students are for industrial training. They get it from here, like people from Birembo, War Memorial Institute, people from Koki Haibale, people from Kibale Institute. They do their industrial training from here. And those people, when they go out, they tell other people that there is something big in Busesa. Come and see. So you have to come and sign here for whoever comes in here. Now, we also have this is for 2021. Now, this is for farm record. If this doctor has worked, the agrovet doctor has worked on these pigs, must show how many pigs have been worked on, and which disease was he treating? Which drugs has he used? So that it helps us. In case, after treating, we find maybe we have lost some of the piglets, we question that drug. At times we follow up that drug because we write the source of these drugs and the suppliers, we have our key suppliers, we don't easily change. So that if we get any problem, we shall come to that person to tell us that your drug you gave us affected our pigs. So even our suppliers are aware. They don't just supply us. So all that has to be reported. Now, we have this receipt book. This one, it is called the Busesa Community Projects. When we said, you have to make sure you get a receipt. To make sure I don't, even if I'm not around, somebody takes a pig, I'll just come and count the receipts. I will know how much has been worked on in a certain day. So this helps me at the end. This has been worked as well as my cash book. This cash book is very important because I may not go in to look if I'm tired. And I make sure every day I have to review my records. The cashier has to bring all these books for the facility, for the mobile money, for the agent banking, for the farm. They have to be in my room. Every day they close. So even if I come at one night, at least I will pass an eye into this cash book. And this cash book, the good thing with it, it will always have its totals down. If I don't have time and I'm tired, I'll just look at the total down, how much money is there. Yes, there are times, actually now, a day, if I can tell you now my income, a day I can, I'm between 800,000 to 2.5 million in a day. That is if I collected the money from these animals, from the poultry, we have sold some goats, we have sold some milk, we have sold some fish maybe. Even in the mobile money, you find I have collected at least there. But the expense also is minimal. I looked at it and how did I do that? I have a working staff of 38 workers. 38 workers. But the biggest number is in Airtel company and agent banking company. In here, I have a staff of 6 workers. Those 2 work here and they feed the cow here in a cattle fattening structure. 2 work, take goats around. Then the other 2 are the other side of the fish ponds. So 6, but the head is this aggravate doctor.
Supremely paramount on the farm is the provision of security, which cannot be overlooked given the 2.5-acre land holds multiple ventures such as aquaculture, piggery, cattle keeping and poultry. How is Dr. Lubega addressing this critical concern on his farm?
Because I thought it right to get somebody who is technical to monitor these people, to guide them so that we don't make losses. Because when you look at this project, it's now mega. You don't just have to leave it like that. You have to get somebody technical who can identify a problem very fast. Then this project alone, I'm telling you, it also supported me when I was going to Kenya, because they had to ask for who would go there. It was kind of advert. Who would go to Kenya to study about the rearing long-horned grasshopper and other insects for food and feed. They asked for our profile. I had put in my profile of what I'm doing here. I was selected. Then I had to fly to Kenya. Actually, I've flown to Kenya 4 times, going to have those trainings and come. Actually, I came and started the rearing grasshoppers. There is a structure there. And when I started, actually, I reared them for 1 year. But when I went to university, I left these people working, but they mishandled them. Then my grasshoppers died. But but I had them. Many people would come here to tour, and I'm going to repeat it again. I'm going to do it again. Then we used to do growing maggots from black soldier fry. Those maggots, they are very important as a source of protein. So you don't have to buy these pellets. Just get your maggots, put them into a bit lukewarm water, they die, mix it into the feed, give them first class protein. I have all that knowledge. Actually, everywhere now, like here, that's why I said I have my things in one place. I have my goats there, I have my pigs here, I have my poultry there, and cows there. I have one security personnel who covers the facility and these animals. All the night is patrolling.
Variations in performance are a natural part of any endeavor or commercial undertaking. During our interview, we endeavored to elicit from Dr. Lubega a discussion of the obstacles he confronts in managing his farm, given the multitude of enterprises it accommodates.
Yes, this project also has some challenges. The challenge we have, the most important one is the fake agro inputs. You find, at times you buy these acaricides, maybe you want to spray for these flies on the cattle. You buy it expensively, you go and spray, you find the cattle is not, the flies do not even move away. You find also these concentrates. There is one concentrate we bought, because for us we know, when we buy a concentrate and we give our pigs, we know how much it can add on. Within 2 weeks, because our target is within 2 weeks, we can start selling to our buyers. But we gave this, actually the piglets did not grow. Instead, we saw them getting hairy. And when you see hairy, you know the thing has not worked. There was no nutrient, I believe, because the whole phase did not come up. And you find you have around 80 piglets, 100 piglets, and you have bought the thing, you know it is going to work. Then the thing becomes hairy. I lost that, and people could not buy.
The fact that Dr. Lubega, a professional doctor, has established a medical center, agent banking, aquaculture, piggery farm, goat farm, poultry, and his home on a mere 2.5-acre piece of land is a valuable lesson to all individuals with expertise in various fields. It highlights the potential of agriculture as a transformative tool that can positively impact the lives of people within and around one's community. Therefore, we can all draw inspiration from Dr. Lubega's success and recognize that even on a small piece of land, one can achieve great things through agriculture.
This knowledge deserves recognition as per other esteemed professions. We witness the success of Dr. Lubega Richard as a capable medical practitioner and as a successful farmer at the same time. I think we should all learn from this. The search for the best farmer is still going on, and this is sponsored by the Netherlands Embassy in Uganda, Royal Dutch Airlines, DFCU Bank, and Cowdays. Lastly, we take our sincere appreciation to the organizers, the Vision Group. This has been the Harvest Spanish Show. My name is Rosemary Tukundani. Till next time, bye-bye.